This time, we're catching up with house hunters who were looking for their perfect match.
I wonder how big it actually is.
Small, but perfectly formed.
Yeah.
Whether you listen to your heart...
Oh, good, wow.
Or just follow your nose...
Yes, Lucy did just fart. She's going to pin it on Phil, but...
The course of true love rarely runs smooth.
I think nude sunbathing probably wouldn't be on the cards. Yeah.
Hopefully now they've found their happily ever after.
I was up for rolling up our sleeves and going for it.
This time, we're catching up with a house hunter whose guide dog had some fascinating reactions to some of the houses, as well as a pair of newlyweds who wanted to be away from the buzz of the city, but not too far from the local pub. In 2014, newlyweds Liz and Carl were looking for their first marital home in Hertfordshire. And in 2016, web developer Lynn was looking to upgrade her Bangor home. She was craving a conservatory and hoping to add an extra bedroom. Blind since birth, Lynn was searching for a home for herself and her faithful assistant's dog, Lucy.
All of my houses, my dogs have helped me choose them. Lucy's a very good judge of atmosphere. I found her in a rescue centre in London. She was a crazy dog, you know. I've done a lot of work with her. She's just an amazing dog now.
After living in London for 20 years, Lynn moved back home to be closer to her mum.
I was offered a great job in Bangor. So I thought, live by the sea, this is just perfect, and she can move up. So she was really looking for somewhere with a downstairs bedroom and bathroom, you know, because her health isn't so good.
Lynn found somewhere that fitted the bill, but the plan changed last year after romance blossomed for her mum.
She met this lovely guy, fell madly in love, so she doesn't need my room anymore.
And Lynn's decided that's a chance for her to move on as well. Studying for a degree in psychology, she's looking to sell her current home and buy something better suited to her needs.
I know it's a bit crazy because I've only bought it 3 years ago and I've invested everything I've got in it, but just go for it.
And she isn't afraid of taking risks. This is a woman who's travelled around the world.
A blind person going around the world, it's completely crazy. We went to South America first, New Zealand, Australia, Southeast Asia for a while, and we spent 2.5 months in India. And it was completely mad because I honestly can't read maps or anything.
But now, finding a new home is proving just as much of a mission.
Searching for a house is a bit of a different process for me than it would be for most people. I can't see the photographs on the website, so to do my online search, I use a computer with a screen reader built in. And I've got it really speeded up, so it's very difficult for anyone else to understand.
Public transport, schools, and easy access to all arterial routes. Dog viewing would be highly recommended for this immaculate modern family home.
I'm sure your dulcet tones can improve on that, Phil.
They'll need to. After searching for over a year, Lynn's yet to find a house that comes with the conservatory she's dying for.
If you ask me if it was more difficult getting around the world with your eyes shut or finding a conservatory in Bangor, well, I'm really struggling with the conservatory thing.
It's going to be a challenge for us both. This is my first ever search with a house hunter who's blind.
So, Lynn, you moved back from London 4 years ago.
Yep.
Bought yourself a house.
I was kind of in a rush to... I just bought a house with no conservatory, which is like, oh, what did I do that for?
Can we just talk a bit about your likes, dislikes?
I would like a nice big kitchen with enough space that I can... like, put a sofa or a small table and chairs or something in there. Because I quite like, you know, cooking and having a friend around and we're sitting chatting or whatever.
How do you want me to kind of guide you around the viewings?
You're going to be painting a picture with words, right? And you can pretend to be a low-budget version of yourself looking for a house. And your other half is abroad and can't come with you and you're describing this house to her. That would really work for me.
Well, I'm in your hands.
Yay!
To get me started, Lynn and Lucy are taking me to their current home for a spot of training.
OK, we're at the front door. We've got our step, which you'll be very familiar with.
Yep, that's good.
I don't know why I say it's our step. It's your step at the moment.
Darling. I don't suppose you want to carry me over the threshold
now. I'll give it a go.
Focus on the job at hand, Phil.
So I would want to know what size the room is, mm-hmm. how high the ceilings are,
yeah.
what colour the floor is, and how big the windows are.
Yeah, but the kitchen is going to be the most important room.
It really is, because this is the room I use most in the house. Look, I would like a bit more light coming into my kitchen.
A bit more light?
Yes.
I mean, for a blind person, light is still very important.
It's a bit silly, right? So I can see light, I can't see anything else, so yeah. I may as well make the most of the one thing that I can't see.
Got it. Yeah. And as we go round the viewing, if there's an interesting feature, I'll go to it like that.
Well, just grab a hand okay. and put it on there. Okay. That'd be good. If there was anything specific that stood out, if the cooker's built in, mm-hmm. it'd be great if you could say to me, oh, look at this, there's a range cooker, and then I could maybe touch it.
Yeah. How about Lucy?
She didn't like the house.
Yeah.
She'd be quite agitated.
Well, you both got to be happy. That's yeah. important.
So Lucy's doing atmosphere.
I'll do bricks and mortar.
Okay.
Let's go house hunting.
Lucy's like, okay, then.
I get the feeling Lucy may be high maintenance, Phil.
Nothing I'm not used to, then.
With the money Lynn will be making from selling her house and a small mortgage, she has a total budget of £115,000.
She's after a house with at least two bedrooms and ideally a third to turn into a study and hobby room. Lots of light is a must, as is a kitchen that's large enough for socialising. Lynn loves the area where she currently lives in the seaside town of Bangor, County Down. So I'll be casting my property net within a mile of her current home. And almost 500 miles away, we're on the hunt in picture-perfect Hertfordshire and the county's popular city of St Albans. A home was needed for Liz and Carl, a pair of loved-up newlyweds.
People say that you know when it's right, and it sort of pretty quickly worked out that, you know, this was the one.
It's all been just pretty dreamy, really.
The only nightmare was Carl's three-hour round trip to Amersham, where he works in car leasing. So 8 months ago, they moved 40 miles north from their rental flat in Greenwich to St Albans.
Living here has halved his commute while keeping Liz close enough to her job in London as director of a military charity.
Having sensibly rented first to get a feel for it, they're happy St Albans has a similar buzz to Greenwich and are now very eager to buy.
Now we're married, settled down. And now is the time to make that decision as quickly as possible
for me. Find our first home together.
Although they're now officially settled down, this is not a forever nest, just a 3 to 5 year home, as they're not planning on swapping socialising for slippers just yet.
We'd like to be near a nice pub, very important for Mr. P.
Walking distance of a nice pub.
And ideally, the house itself will have enough space to entertain friends. But other than that, they're keeping their options wide open.
I think there's very little that we would rule out.
Let's see if I can't coax a little clarity out of them.
It's going to be much easier for you guys if you're clear about what the specifics are that you want.
Our preference would be for a house. That's not to say if we saw the right apartment, that we wouldn't take it.
I'm desperately trying to narrow your search down and give it focus, and you're trying to open it up.
We almost want the character house with the open plan feel of the modern flat.
Kirsty, help!
Best of British, Phil.
At least Liz and Carl are clear that their top budget is £450,000.
For that, they'd want a tip-top two-bed property with some character within commuting distance of both Amersham and London.
Liz, in particular, wants private outdoor space, and walking distance to a pub is important to Carl. Well, that's what I think they're saying at this point, but I'm not convinced this is going to be a straightforward search. I'm starting off with an early 1900s cottage in the very desirable Bernard's Heath Conservation Area of St Albans. It's close to the high street hustle and bustle thereafter, so bang on location-wise.
I really like the outside of it. I like the bay window.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I like the street.
Top mark so far, Pip.
This terraced cottage offers character and more space than they might imagine, with two bedrooms and a bathroom upstairs and two separate living areas downstairs, plus Liz's preferred private garden. They say they're open to anything. Would they be open to doing work?
It's been a rental property, and there is some upgrading required, but that's doable, as it's £25,000 under budget at £425,000.
I thought this was going to be a lot worse condition than it is. I quite like it.
It feels nice and open. Obviously, it doesn't have any furniture in it yet.
Fine, let's see some more.
There's additional living space off the kitchen, in what was originally the bathroom.
Wow.
And if you got planning permission, there's potential to extend into the side return and create a wonderful dining kitchen.
Fantastic.
We're almost sold on the first one.
That's fine. Early lunch.
I'd hold off on asking for the menu just yet, Pip. In moving the bathroom from downstairs to up, compromises have been made, especially in the second bedroom.
I wonder how big it actually is.
The second bedroom, I sort of, that needs a little bit more thought, whether that would work. I mean,
that really is small.
What you get in return is the bathroom being upstairs and you've got the extra living space or dining room. Yeah.
And a sunny garden.
Just today.
I'm sensing a possible maybe, Phil.
No, I like it.
Ready for the next one?
Yep.
Yes.
Come on then, moving on.
Given this pair said they wouldn't rule anything out, I suspect everything could be a possible maybe, unless we manage to focus their search.
We? I'm afraid that's up to you, Mr. Spencer.
We're catching up with two sets of house hunters whose searches had their own particular challenges. Liz and Carl were struggling with specifics.
I think there's very little that we would rule out.
While in Bangor, Lynn knew exactly what she wanted for her and her assistant's dog, Lucy.
So Lucy's doing atmosphere.
I'll do bricks and mortar.
OK.
Bangor is one of Northern Ireland's main tourist towns, and Lynn loves where she currently lives, but yearns for a home that's lighter and brighter. Just under a mile from her current house, the first property I'm taking her to is close to the main street and the seaside.
So, we're pretty much a stone's throw from the marina, so,
yeah,
you know, really, really close.
Yeah, I think that's why Lucy's very excited, because she can smell the sea.
As Lynn can't see the property, it's up to me to describe it.
It's a semi-detached house.
OK.
Two windows downstairs, two windows upstairs.
Are there big or small windows?
They are medium.
OK.
How am I doing?
This is good.
My descriptive powers.
Yeah, this is brilliant.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, OK, follow me.
Location-wise, this property's spot-on, and it's in walk-in condition. There are two reception rooms, a decent-sized kitchen, and three bedrooms.
Although spacious, coming this close to the marina and main street does mean sacrificing a conservatory.
But it's still the biggest house I'm showing Lynn. While that's taken it nearly $5,000 over budget, I believe a deal could be done.
I want to get you into the kitchen at the back of the house. Now, really modern, contemporary kitchen. We've got units on three sides.
It's like formica or something?
That's formica.
Yeah.
Very fresh, clean and tidy. There's nowhere to sit. However, we're straight through.
Yes.
Into the dining room.
OK.
Even with a table, there would still be room for sofa or an
armchair. Oh, good. So I could still sit around.
Yeah. When we came in, Lucy was really keen to get in the door.
Yeah, she was. She was like, yeah, I like it already.
Yeah.
Yep, that's a good sign for me.
With three bedrooms upstairs, Lynn could have the hobby room she's after.
I think it's at this level you appreciate the space that the house has.
Oh, good. Wow.
Good work, Pip. Lynn and Lucy both seem keen. But there's one problem you haven't revealed.
I'm getting to it.
Now, this is the rub of the house. There is no conservatory here, I'm afraid, Lynn, and no opportunity to build one.
That's a big downer for me, I have to admit.
Looks like the lack of conservatory could be a deal-breaker, Pip.
I feel like I'm compromising on two fronts here, and they're the two most important fronts. So there's the entertaining kitchen, and there's the conservatory, or the option to build one. And this house doesn't have either.
No.
That's the cost of being so close to the main street and marina. But clearly for Lynn, it's not a price worth paying.
Well, big learning curve for me today. And I think over the next few days, there'll be plenty more of that for both Lynn and I. But I love how opinionated Lynn is. She does really know what she wants. And she definitely wants a conservatory. And that's going to cause something of a problem for me. But I am absolutely determined to crack this.
Over in Hertfordshire, my first property for Liz and Carl was well received in many ways.
Wow.
But a search narrowed to sought after St Albans means paying a high price for sizeable compromises. So I'm planning on broadening their horizons. They're open to both location and style. But for my second property, I'm testing them geographically and swapping Hertfordshire for Buckinghamshire. And it's pretty market town of Chesham.
It's very convenient for Carl's work, and there's a tube link to central London for Liz.
Here, they can get a lot more for their money. The average property price is around 100 grand less than in St Albans. And another bonus is that the straight-talking Kirsty is joining us.
First thoughts about where we are.
I have absolutely no idea where we are in relation to London. But other than that, very excited to be here.
If it was a little village green and there was a nice little pub here, I might feel a little bit different. It does feel a little bit out of it.
Let's have a look.
After you. Whoops.
Have you got a good handle on this search, Phil?
I'm sure you'll help me get a grip if I don't. Carl may have a change of heart once he sees they get 200 square feet more here than in St Albans. Two equal-sized bedrooms and a bathroom upstairs. Plus, if their priorities were to shift focus to a family, there's potential to convert the loft.
Downstairs, the proportions are equally generous and stylish, with a decked area outside that leads to a communal garden.
And at offers over £350,000, it should come in well under budget.
You get this, all of this, for
£350,000. Wow.
Yeah, that's more interesting.
Wow.
When you say that. But would we really miss that walking out the front door, walking down to the pub that we have now?
Well, the price might be right, but he really does want to be close to a cold pint.
But I don't think you get to decide on a house based on that. Hopefully a bit of time with Liz will help us get to the bottom of what they really need from a home.
Promise me you'll tread softly.
Baby steps, obviously, Phil. Starting with Liz's thoughts on the outside space.
It's quite overlooked.
I think nude sunbathing probably wouldn't be on the cards.
Yeah. Mm, well, that is disappointing, naturally, but it's a lovely, lovely decking area.
And don't forget the communal garden.
It's great from a family perspective.
I see what you did there.
And is this planning to be a family house?
Well, I think we wouldn't rule anything out.
Right.
But it's not on the cards sort of immediately.
Immediate or not, you don't want the deck stacked against you in terms of house size. A forced move in a few years could cost Liz and Carl around £25,000. So the longer they can stay somewhere, the better. I hope you're making that clear upstairs, Phil.
Just about to play my hand.
You've got the option to go up into the loft.
Right.
So in terms of longevity,
yeah. This
house really could grow with you.
You're right, this house would enable us to be able to stay longer if our lifestyle changed in the future.
They really aren't ruling anything out. Style of house, area, future plans.
Mm. That's a nice room.
Well, I'm trying to get him to think longer term, but I don't know if I'm really succeeding.
Me too.
It's difficult to plan for the future. I mean, you know, none of us know what the future holds.
Is it better now to buy something like this, which is the budget is very attractive,
yeah. And
know that if things change, we can stay here?
Tough discussions upstairs, but in the garden, it's time for Pip to own up that he agrees with my way of thinking.
You always thought that people didn't focus enough on when they were having kids. Now you finally had to admit it. For years, you have...
I've felt like that all the time I've ever known you. I've just been hiding it. So now you've outed me.
Of course, not everyone has to think the way I do, but it is our duty to point out the pitfalls of a short-term buy.
How are you two getting on? Moved in yet?
Not quite.
It's definitely an option.
It's very difficult because there's a lot of stuff within this conversation that's none of our business.
Yeah.
I don't often say that.
I'm absolutely gobsmacked, Kirsty.
This is definitely food for thought.
That's me, you've got a banquet of a chat coming on.
And if their priorities change, will it be feast or famine for the rest of our search? In Bangor, I've had a less than spectacular start, so I've called for backup.
How's it going?
All to play for.
That means not very well.
No, it was fine. What you could really help with is your powers of description. Imagine you're looking around a house, your other half is somewhere abroad, and you've got to describe to him down the phone what it's like. I think you'd be very good at that.
When did you discover she needed that from you?
Well, no, that's how she described it.
Don't
be sarky. I'm just telling you how she described it to me, and you're very difficult to work with sometimes. You really are.
I don't know what you mean, but hopefully this won't be a difficult viewing. Our next property is just over 5 minutes' walk from where Lynn currently lives and close to her mum.
I mean, I love this location already. This is a perfect location for me.
It's a sort of brick construction, concrete underneath. It's not a looker.
Yeah.
You know, it's your Phil Spencer house rather than your...
Thank you very much indeed. Solid, reliable, good value, all of those things.
This well-presented mid-terrace villa offers the open-plan kitchen that Lynn's desperate for. There are three bedrooms and a spacious lounge.
The enclosed back garden has the added bonus of an outside workshop, which could make a fabulous hobby room for Lynn. And crucially, there's the opportunity to extend out to create a sunroom.
And that would be affordable, because another big selling point of this place is the price. It's well under budget, at just shy of 90 grand.
So we're now facing a fireplace.
Yeah.
If you feel here, there's a sort of slightly art deco-y decorative feature, ooh, which is nice.
Yeah, that's
now, the kitchen leaps and bounds better than...
Oh, it's much bigger than it.
you can tell from my voice.
Yes. Yeah.
The kitchen gets a thumbs up, but there is one concern. The steep steps at the front, as Lucy suffers from arthritis.
As she gets older, it might be an issue for her.
Mm.
I presume that it might get to a point where she couldn't help you in the way you wanted
her
to.
Yeah, she wouldn't be, but I would still be keeping her as a pet.
Yes. Mm. I keep Phil as a pet.
Yeah.
A very loyal pet.
So like
long-suffering pet.
His face is a picture.
So that's how much she loves me.
We may be laughing, but Lucy's not looking too happy.
Lucy's not mad about this house. She doesn't even want to be in this room.
She does look a little sorrowful.
I just walk somewhere with her. I just see where she tries to bring me. Come, Liz.
She's trying to go straight out the door.
That's interesting.
She doesn't want to be in this house, look.
She's not a happy dog, Phil. Have you got any treats?
Afraid not. But Lynn's liking it, so it's not over yet.
Right, so there's a step down.
At the beginning of all of this, Lynn said to me that Lucy would handle the atmosphere of a place and that I was going to be in charge of the actual bricks and mortar. I feel like I've got the bricks and mortar right here, but I'm worried about Lucy. I think she's going to turn her nose up at it.
If you move forward, you'll feel there's a wall.
Yeah.
Can you feel that, Dan? There we are. Yeah. And that's a boxed-in area.
So that is how far my
your sunroom would come. Okay. I mean, it would be lovely. Your kitchen would be flooded with light first thing in the morning. Yeah. So it would be the ideal house at which to have a sunroom. Yeah.
Mm.
Lynn seems impressed, Kirsty, but let's see if your words have worked on Lucy.
She does seem much more...
She is. She's a lot more chilled out. Yeah, no, she really likes upstairs for some reason.
Yeah?
She likes it.
Lynn, how are you feeling?
There's a lot fewer compromises to make than there were yesterday. Nice big kitchen. It'd be brilliant to be able to push it right out and make a big, lovely sunroom.
Yeah.
Well, that could be one in the running for both owner and dog.
OK, Lucy, we're all happy. Let's move on.
She just
farted. Yes, Lucy did just fart. I'm going to pin it on Phil, but...
Back in St Albans, it seems our gentle prodding about any future family aims has really hit home with Liz and Carl.
I think what we're probably coming to the conclusion is that that family plan is very, very likely to be the plan.
That means thinking about how they'd manage the mortgage if they had just a single salary.
Anything around the 400 would
down.
Be... Yeah, down. Okay. Just under 400 would start to make things easier to plan.
Yeah.
I think that is very, very sensible, but it does throw some fairly large challenges into my search, given that I've got an absolute blinder to show you in St Albans at 450,000.
All laughing aside, it's a whole new search, and the properties we've seen so far don't work for it. And with 50 grand less to spend, they still want the same kind of house. At least two beds, character, and outside space. So after a phoning frenzy, the only thing I can do is push them out further. For our third property, we're heading half an hour from St Albans to Tring.
There's a mini St Albans vibe to this market town, which should definitely appeal, and living here would mean a 20-minute drive to work for Carl and a 40-minute train ride to London for Liz.
I found them an end-of-terrace Victorian cottage in the sought-after Tring Triangle Conservation Area, a mere stone's throw from the High Street hustle and bustle they love. Didn't I do well?
It's not about you, Phil. It's not about you.
It is, I think, a really very pretty cottage.
Wonderful.
First impressions, it looks amazing.
Yeah, looks lovely.
It's been back on the market for a day after a sale fell through. This Victorian terrace may well surprise, with three bedrooms upstairs, kitchen and living on street level, and a converted cellar. At just under £400,000, we're at the very top of their new budget.
Small, but perfectly formed.
Yeah.
I like
really
it.
Really lovely.
The style and finish throughout is likely to be right up Liz and Carl's street.
Oh, fantastic.
That's
a nice little...
added another layer, isn't it?
Three bedrooms is a major bonus, although they're not huge, and Liz does like plenty of wardrobe space.
If it didn't have those,
yeah,
then we'd be in a different ballpark.
Yeah.
But the fact that it's got one that could actually have someone staying in and still have the other one with dressing room space...
The house is offering quite a lot. Mm.
And they've not even seen the bonus in the basement yet.
Have a look downstairs. Two rooms... See what you could do with them. One of them could be a wonderful playroom.
You really are starting to sound like me, Phil. The property is actually being marketed as having 3 to 4 bedrooms because of the cellar conversion.
Down there is a good-sized utility room.
Oh, fantastic.
A bit more than I expected. Yeah.
And wait, there's more.
Oh, wow. Gosh. And an extra... Ah, so this is where they've got their TV.
Come on. Yeah.
Ah.
Carl and Liz are making all the right noises.
Absolute shocker for my property, so they've reduced the budget. But at least they finally had the conversation about whether or not a family is part of the plan.
You seem quite positive.
Yeah.
Quite open-minded too.
Yeah.
It's lovely.
It is. It's a lovely house. And I think I found it quite surprising going downstairs, because I wasn't expecting it to A, be as big or as well developed. Mm. Or offer us as much as it does.
They seem enthused, but with such a radical reduction in budget, I hope this property offers enough to bring my search to an end. We're back with two sets of house hunters whose searches posed some very particular challenges. In Hertfordshire, priorities changed for Liz and Carl.
That family plan is very, very likely to be the plan.
And in Bangor, Lynn's top priority means she's had to consider a project.
So that is how far my
Your sunroom would come.
Okay.
But this next place could save her the trouble.
Just a street away from her current house, location-wise, it's a winner.
It's actually a modern house.
Mm.
And it's set back off the street. Mm-hmm. The curb's been dropped.
Yes.
And there's no step.
Oh, that's quite good.
Come on then, follow
Let's
me.
Let's do it.
Although this isn't the biggest house I'm showing Lynn, the inside more than makes up for it. Set over two floors, this modern mid-terrace has three bedrooms, one of which is ensuite. There's a lovely lounge and, best of all, a big and bright kitchen diner.
All of this comes at a price, though, £120,000 to be exact. But we're confident we could bring it in on budget.
Slight angle through. Lucy's very keen to go in there. That's the living room to our left.
Okay.
She is
likes that.
Really sniffing and twitching. Her little nose is going everywhere. So we're into the kitchen. Good. I'm fascinated by her reaction. This is so animated.
Yeah, she's loving it.
Lots of units, lots of storage space, plenty of work surface.
Is the surface a different colour from the...
Yes, the surface is darker.
OK.
It's a kitchen diner.
Yes.
There is plenty of room for a dining table and somewhere to sit.
Yes.
But I think the real joy of this is the fact that it's got double French windows straight out to the garden. You don't need a conservatory.
No, this is a great kitchen.
For all intents and purposes, it's a sunroom.
Yeah, this is going to be lovely and sunny, isn't it?
Yeah.
Looks like Lynn and Lucy are lapping up this property.
What do you think, Lucy Lou?
This is a more expensive house than the second one, but it doesn't need any work doing to it. It's pretty much got a south-facing sunroom. It doesn't have any steps on the ground floor. And Lucy seems to love it.
What do you think, Lucy Lou?
Yeah, have a sniff.
Do you like it?
Yeah.
She really seems very animated by it.
I think upstairs could well seal the deal.
So, master bedroom,
yeah.
It has an ensuite shower room.
Oh, this is so cool.
Yeah?
Yeah. I'd really love to let Lucy go and see what she does, if that's okay.
Absolutely. Let's do it now.
Go, go. Off you go.
Paddle straight off downstairs.
Ooh.
Well, we're always after decisive house hunters, and Lucy is certainly that.
Seen something remarkable from Lucy in this house.
Yeah, because it sounds a bit like crazy dog lady when you say my dog's going to help me choose my house.
She really has.
Hey, big dog. Even if I don't make an offer, Lucy's going to.
The dilemma here is obviously, it is lovely, but it's considerably more money.
Yeah.
Even if we can negotiate the price down a bit.
Yeah.
So we've got some thinking to do.
Yeah.
Still torn, Lynn wants to take another look at the cheaper property too. She liked this house, but Lucy seemed uncomfortable, so we're here to see if she's changed her mind.
I want to let her make her decision.
Yeah. OK.
That's OK. If she could be let off, just have a sniff around, see where she goes, that'd be good. Shall we do that?
Let's do it. Absolutely. Good luck, Lucy.
Wait.
OK.
Right, so...
She's gone into the house.
Go check it out, big dog.
Bouncing in. She did a 360 in the living room, straight back out. She is trying to tell us something.
She really is. She's made her decision, I think. Who is she?
Yes.
This is really confusing for me.
Lucy has made her feelings clear, but that gives Lynn a tough decision to make.
Difficult. What I've just seen happen with Lucy is one of the most fascinating bits of house hunting I've ever experienced. Lucy understands Lynn can't see her and her body language, so she had to make it abundantly clear what she was feeling. And I think she was very obviously telling Lynn not to go for that house. Whether Lynn will follow that lead or not, I don't know.
Over in Hertfordshire, after a second viewing, Liz and Carl have fallen for the house in Tring and want to make an offer. We need to be quick. It's only just come back on the market, but they've already had several viewings. In our favour is the fact the vendors are in a chain and their previous sale has fallen through.
So they're slightly between a rock and a hard place because they need a buyer quickly and a good one. However, interest is mounting. You know, they're seeing people come through the door, so I don't think it's going to be a steal.
The asking price is 400 grand, bang on their revised budget amount. But Carl and Liz want to do some bargaining.
I'd have to sort of have a think about the value for money we're getting coming out here if we start this with a four.
390, I think, let's go for it.
Caroline, it's Phil Spencer. They would be willing to pay the 390. Yes. OK. Understood. Thanks, Caroline. Bye. If I was a betting man, I would put money on. She'll ring back and say, they want 395. You'll have to do better. Thank you.
Right.
Drink.
As predicted, the vendors have refused 390. So if Carl and Liz want to stop the raft of second viewings from other interested parties, they're going to have to bid more.
OK. Let's push it to 395, but we'd like washing machine, kitchen, fridge, freezer, you know, as much of that as we could get.
Should it?
Yes, please. Thank
Good you. Decision, well made.
Our best and final offer of £395,000 is going in, and we don't have to wait long.
Do we have a deal? That's fantastic. Bye-bye. You have bought a house.
Excellent.
Yay.
Well done.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thanks very much.
Your house hunt is officially over.
Yay.
The twists and turns were all worth it in the end. It's a great result for Liz and Carl.
Fabulous.
Excellent. Well
done. Very exciting. Yes.
Many congratulations.
Thank you.
In Bangor, there are two houses on the table. Property 2 is well under budget, with scope to build a sunroom, but didn't pass the doggy test. Property 3 was a winner, but it's likely to cost at least 20 grand more than Property 2.
Lucy sort of made my mind up because she still was unsure about the second one. Both of us love the third one.
Yeah. You're not getting a conservatory, but you're getting a really light, lovely...
bright kitchen.
Yeah.
Lucy wants to make an offer. I think she's right.
Should we go for it?
Yeah.
So property three's a goer, but it's £5,000 over Lynn's £115,000 budget, and she's yet to sell her own house, so far from straightforward.
I wouldn't be able to offer more than 115.
There was an offer of 112 that was declined. I think 115 would be the right figure to try and buy it at.
Mm.
I'll call the agent. Right, fingers crossed and paws crossed, please, Lucy.
Paws crossed.
Rachel, hello, it's Phil Spencer. Hi.
As Lynn hasn't sold her house yet, I'm going to try and negotiate a price that the vendor would accept once her house is under offer.
Lynn has got her house on the market. I do have an offer for you, I'm delighted to say, which is £115,000. I should perhaps also add that that's as far as we can go. £115,000 is top whack. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Now we have an anxious wait.
How are you feeling, Lynn?
Very, very edgy. Like, I've never been in.
Here we go. Hi, Rachel. Okay. So, okay. I understand. Yes, please. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Okay. Thanks, Rachel. Thank you. Bye bye. So, what she said is, if you were in a position to proceed with your house under offer, he'll give 115 serious consideration. Happy?
Yes, that's great, thank you.
So, as soon as Lynn sells her current house, I reckon her offer will be accepted.
Let's raise a glass to that. Cheers to you both.
Cheers.
Very nice working with you, and you, Lucy.
Unfortunately, Lynn didn't manage to sell her house quickly enough to secure the property. And a busy few years shifted her focus away from house hunting, including her mum's marriage to partner Victor.
My goodness, 78-year-old, she was all loved up. And she ended up moving up here and marrying him.
It was all change on the job front too.
I was offered a job in West Yorkshire, so I moved to Rochdale. The original property I had in Bangor, I rented that out. So I lived in Rochdale for about 2 years, and then sadly, my mum passed away. So I came home to spend some time with my family and just didn't go back.
Lynn has been back since early 2020, and though her return to Bangor began in sad circumstances, she now has the home she set out to find all those years ago. She and Lucy have recently moved into a bright and spacious three-bed semi-detached house a short walk from the town centre.
The first time Lucy came into this house, she ran in the side door, came into the back room, started rolling around on the floor. She absolutely loved it.
Lynn was able to increase her budget, securing the new property for £170,000, and although it didn't meet the brief, she's very happy with the outcome.
At first I was quite sad that I couldn't get a house with a conservatory, but after I moved in here, you know, the sun was shining all day on that decking, and I started to sit out there and think, ah, who needs a conservatory anyway?
As well as the decked garden, Lynn has two reception rooms downstairs. There's a bright lounge diner, as well as plenty of room for a dedicated office, where she works as a design engineer, improving website accessibility.
It's a US company and we all work from home, so it was a real relief to be able to work from home and actually bring my job back to Bangor with me.
Lynn has a well-equipped kitchen, offering all the social space she wanted, and complemented by the relaxing garden.
This is a really great house for entertaining, so I've had, I think, maybe three lots of friends come over from England since I moved in. And I've got a nice big table that can just about sit eight people. And I've got the decking area, which I'm going to fill up with garden furniture and a barbecue.
While it took a little longer than hoped, it's clear Lynn has found her forever home.
I think spending that time with Phil really helped me gain perspective about the property market, what I could afford, what I really wanted, what I wouldn't compromise on. I just put it all together and found my perfect house. Bangor's my happy place. It's just, I love being by the sea.
I love being able to walk to all of the shops that I need to get to. And look, this is perfect. What else could anybody want? This is really my happy place.
That's really great to hear after an eventful search.
Phil, tell the truth next time. It wasn't Lucy that farted and you knew it.
I'm saying nothing. But it does seem like Lynn and Lucy are happily settled by the sea. In Hertfordshire, Liz and Carl got the keys to their new house soon after our search. I went back a year later and they'd been very busy.
Hello!
Hello!
Hang on, where's the kitchen?
This is a bit different.
We decided we didn't need one.
Yeah. It's all change.
Liz and Carl had redone the entire house. They'd redecorated each of the three bedrooms, but it was the living space that had seen the biggest change. The kitchen was knocked through to make a much larger lounge, and in the cellar, the TV room and utility had been used to create a stunning dining kitchen.
Oh, wow. Wow. Oh, my word. You have been hard at work. Really, really smart. You have transformed it.
Thank you.
It's a good party kitchen.
How long did it take?
Probably from the builders moving in to moving out, I think about 3 months, best part of 3 months.
And meanwhile, you were...
Living upstairs in two bedrooms with a microwave and...
How was it?
A few takeaways.
Very unglamorous.
Yeah, but well worth it. My favourite room. I spend all my time down here. I love it.
Now, after 6 years, I'm back again to see Liz and Carl. And the changes are even bigger. The last time I saw Liz and Carl, they transformed the first home we found them in Hertfordshire.
It's all change.
The house in Tring was always planned to be a stepping stone, and now, 6 years on, thanks to some really good interior design skills, Liz and Carl have sold it for a decent profit, which has enabled them to buy a detached home here in the vibrant town of Marlow.
In the past 6 years, the newlyweds we searched with have grown into a family. 4-year-old Felix and 2-year-old India made Mum and Dad realise they had to swap their starter house for a family home.
What was face, Mum?
Hello!
Hello!
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you in Marlow.
How wonderful. Come on in.
They got this stunning 4-bed detached house less than 3 months ago, but it didn't look like this when they bought it.
So this is the kitchen.
It's all super, super smart.
Carl was hoping for a new build. I was up for rolling up our sleeves and going for it.
We came out of here and Liz said, so what did you think? And I said, not for us. Liz said, I like it. I think she put in an offer. And here we are. But we've got a bit more involved than I was planning to do. You know, a lot of the decorating has been done.
There's a theme here, isn't there, Carl? Yeah. There's definitely a theme.
The whole house has been lavished with love. They've opened up and extended to create this show-stopping kitchen diner. And in the lounge, the dated fireplace is gone.
We talked about that house in Tring being a stepping stone, and you wanted to future-proof it because you had family plans, but that obviously turned out.
It certainly did.
Yeah. Well, we're lucky we did because, you know, we weren't really sure. But as it's turned out, you know, we've got two kids and there's four of us now, and we could, you know, we just wouldn't be comfortable in that house.
They spent £35,000 renovating the end terrace in Tring and sold it for £470,000, £75,000 more than they paid for it. That helped them get this house, which they bought for £710,000. The £50,000 they've spent here has undoubtedly added value, but this place has Forever Home written all over it.
It's all so smart, Carl.
It's all new.
It troubles me that you've only been here a month and it just looks like home.
Yeah, well, yeah, absolutely. It's been a long time to get in here, but we're finally there now.
How life changes, eh?
Absolutely, yeah. Kids, does it to you? Great. We need more space, and this has given us more space.
Yeah.
This is just a great room for relaxing in and also, you know, work from here. So the house just offers everything we need, really, for our family now.
Upstairs has been shown just as much care and attention. They've stripped, sanded and painted every inch to give them a really elegant end result. And clearly, more space than they had in Tring.
The main bedroom is huge.
That's it.
It's much bigger.
Much bigger, absolutely.
Really light.
Yes, we're pleased to have the space for the children. As soon as we got here, Felix got out his train sets all over the carpet and just, you know, let it all out. So it was just wonderful.
One of the most important elements of their first search was a good local pub. And though life has moved on considerably for Liz and Carl, I like to think some things don't change.
I've got to ask, though, how close is the pub?
How close is the pub, Felix?
Which one?
Have you been to the pub?
There's
you
so many.
I think it's fantastic. I really, really love it. I love Marlowe. I love the house. I love what you've done. And I love all of you. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. It's lovely to see you.
Thank you.
Well done.
Cheers.
It was always at the back of mine and Kirsty's minds that it wasn't likely to be too long before Liz and Carl were swapping pubs for pushchairs. And that is the picture-perfect home for a family of four to enjoy for years to come. And for Lynn, I'm delighted to see that her and Lucy are so happy and settled in a really bright, welcoming home. I'd say that's two searches that worked out brilliantly.
If you'd like help finding your next home, then we want to hear from you. You can apply online at channel4.com/takepart.